had another sale on eBay, and it is some of these antique Spode plates I found at Goodwill. These are either from the late 1800s or early 1900s, and they're just beautiful. So I found a stack of these at Goodwill. I think I paid $9.99. Listed groups of them separately, such as these two bread plates and these four dessert plates. And someone sent me an offer for $60 for the four dessert plates and $22 for the two little bread plates. And I accepted. I'm gonna send these out. And I still have a dinner plate left and three berry bowls. So they are still available on eBay. So I had another sale on eBay, and it is on this bottom shelf here at the very bottom. It is that beautiful cake plate. So this is an antique cake plate made in Germany with the beautiful pink roses on it. I only paid $1.99 for this at Goodwill, and it sold for $20. I'm getting some plates listed. I just listed this beautiful mint green Majolica plate made in Western Germany. Has a grape and leaf pattern, and it does have crazing, but no chips or cracks. There's a mark on the back. And I recently found this at Goodwill for $1.99. This is from the 1960s. I'm going to list this on eBay and Etsy. Maybe also knickknacks, but for now eBay and Etsy for about $15 or $16. I just listed this vintage German plate with this German Shepherd on it. Very cool plate. It's in excellent condition. This brand, let me turn it the right side. This brand, Schumann Arisberg, is a very old company, started in the 1800s, but this mark is from the 1960s, possibly into the 1970s. But Schumann Arisberg China sells very well. Arisberg is the region in Germany, I believe. Schumann is the name of the founder of the company in the 1800s. But I'm listing this plate on eBay and Etsy for about $15 to $16. I just listed these Pier 1 plates that I found at Goodwill. These are called Posh Pups. And there would have been a fourth plate, but they didn't have it at Goodwill, so I just bought the three. Pier 1 plates are very good to pick up. Some patterns do better than others, but these dog plates sell pretty well. A set of four of them usually sells for between $50 and $60. I'm going to list these three for about $40 on eBay. They are contemporary, so I'm not going to put them on Etsy. I'm not sure when they were made, but Etsy is normally for 20 years or older. But these are really cute. So they will be on eBay. And I paid $2 per plate. I'm finally getting around to listing this Westmoreland pedestal compote dish. I've had this for a few weeks now and just haven't listed it. It originally had a lid. This one does not have its lid, so I had to keep that in mind when pricing it. It looks like it is listed for about $40 with the lid on eBay. I'm gonna put this up at $24.99 or best offer, and I'll probably put it on Etsy as well. I had a whatnot sale yesterday and sold two items, both to the same person. You can tell they love cats. They bought this adorable cat mug that is made in England for $10. I got this for 99 cents. And then they bought this fun cat shelf sitter. I bought this recently at Goodwill. I think I paid $2 or $3. I can't remember. But she bought him for $12. So I'm gonna get these two items wrapped up for her. I usually do my whatnot sales on Saturday mornings around 9 or 10 a.m. Central. And I do stream them to YouTube. I had another sale on eBay, and it's another one of these antique Spode plates. I sold some of the pieces already. This plate is a salad plate. And it is going all the way to Alaska. And it sold for $22.09. I just picked up a small lot of items I won on a local online auction. I haven't bid on anything in a local auction in a while, but I found some really cool things. I'll show them to you when I get home. I only spent $9.94, and I really like the items I got. So yeah, once I get home, I'll show you what they are. So here's my small haul from the auction. I got a bunch of vintage silverware that have really nice pattern to them. This one, the brand is Community Plate. It's probably not gonna, you can kind of see it there. I've looked it up on eBay and they sell pretty well. It is very pretty. So I got all the silverware with this basket for $2. The basket is kind of cool. It's kind of like, I don't know if I'll sell it with all the silverware in it or separately. I haven't decided, but I think I'm going to sell it with the silverware. What do you think I should do? Let me know in the comments. Also, two pieces of jewelry. The first is this really cool fish pendant necklace. It's got like a jeweled eye, so I'll take him out in a minute to get a better look. I think I won him for, let me check the paper, $2. So $2 on the fish. I also got the owl necklace. You can see how big they are. Not sure. I don't have a lot of information about them. They're probably vintage. I'm going to take him out and look him over too. But I won him for $4. So that's everything I got. Not a whole lot. But I should definitely make some money on these items. So let's open the necklaces and get a better look at them. Here they are. They're pretty long and pretty heavy. They're a good weight. I really thought about that. I thought that these necklaces would be good to try out on whatnot or even knickknacks. So I'm probably gonna do that before I list them over on eBay. The owl is really cool. It's a very large pendant with the jeweled eyes. I couldn't find any markings on either one. I'm gonna go over them again, but I think I will try these out on whatnots and knickknacks. And if they don't sell there, I'll put them on eBay. The silverware with the basket is going to be listed on eBay. Possibly Etsy as well. I had another sale on eBay. It's that beautiful hurricane lamp sitting there. Let me get it out and I'll show it to you. Here it is. It's a beautiful hurricane lamp with a yellow rose design and a milk glass base. It does have some wear, as you can see on the graphic, where some of the frosted glass has worn off. There's a spot there too. But it does work. I did plug it in and try it. It's very pretty. I had a lot of watchers on this. Someone sent me an offer for $15 and I accepted it. I just thought I'd show you how I'm gonna pack this. The two pieces are wrapped separately and they're nestled in this box. I like to use plastic bags from the grocery store to kind of give it some cushion around the edges of the box, and that way they won't move when the box shakes. So they're nice and secure in the box. And then I'll put some paper on top. I put lots of packing paper on top to make sure they're very safe down in the box. There's also a layer of packing paper on the bottom underneath the lamp, but it should make it to its buyer safely. I am listing these beautiful glass pieces that I got on my vacation. I'm listing them on Knickknacks only at the moment, just because glass is something that sells really well on Knickknacks. But I will put them on eBay if they don't sell. So I've learned some great things about these. It's very possible that they are Murano, especially this set here. And when I bought this, even the lady at the store, we were both talking about how it really looks like this piece goes with this. And it does. This is a glass perfume bottle. It's kind of large, so I don't know if it's for perfume or something else, but I found a similar one on eBay. It is Sommerso glass. And I think it could be Murano, but I'm not gonna list it as Murano because I don't know for sure. I am not an expert on glass. But this was the topper on that bottle, and the mechanism, the little stem that came off of this broke off. That's why the bottom is rough right there. So I'm pretty sure it is a Murano glass bottle. It's just missing the stem that would go down into the bottle. I'll put a picture up of the other one I found online. Looks pretty similar to this. It's just a different color glass. So I was originally going to list this as a paperweight and a vase, because that's what me and the lady at the thrift store thought it was. But no, it is a bottle with a stopper. The stopper is just missing part of it. So I'm gonna sell it as is, as a bottle with a stopper. I wonder if you could repair it and get a piece on there to make it work again. So when I list this, I'm just gonna list it as is, Sommerso glass bottle with topper, and explain how, you know, it did go together. So somebody still might want it as a decorative piece. They could even just sit it like this on their vanity tray and just not use it. But yeah, mystery is solved. I was wondering about that. So very exciting. I think I'm going to try this at $45 or best offer. And then this paperweight here, which is also very beautiful. I don't think it's Murano though, if I had to guess. But it's still very cool, probably about $25. So I'm getting them listed on Knickknacks today. Well, that'll do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, could you give it a thumbs up? And I will see you in the next one. Bye.